Hello there, everyone. This is your everyone's favorite jack of all trades, Commodore Urban. Thank you for joining me. This is actually a re-record of a video I did the other night, but I didn't upload it because, well, I actually found out some more stuff that I didn't know. And the last video didn't have the new information in it, so instead of sounding like a complete fucking retard, I would put all the information I have learned into the video for the facts. Now, before I begin with the video I'm going to talk about, I wanted to share with you a few things. One, my birthday is coming up on the 21st of March. The Commodore is going to be 28 years old. Yeah, I know, I'll be on this earth for 28 fucking years. Almost three decades. It's crazy to think that. It didn't seem like yesterday I was just a kid. So yeah, it's pretty crazy shit. As for my train fanatics out there, all my people that love my train stuff, I'm going to be doing some more train stuff. And all my ship fanatics, I'm going to do ship stuff too, so don't worry. And of course, I'm going to have a mixture of book reviews and everything else. I had actually just uploaded not too long ago another book review, 50 Ships That Changed the Course of History by Ian Graham. And I hope you guys like that. But anyway, on to the subject of matter. We are going to be talking about the Loud House. And no, we're not talking about the comic books. Even though I do own There Will Be Chaos, There Will Be More Chaos, Family Tree, and After Dark. And I also own this 3-in-1, which has the first two mentioned and Live Life Loud. And no, I am not doing a review on these particular comic books. I'm actually going to be talking about a trend or a group of Loud House artists who have taken things very, very far. And there's even a deviant art group just for this nasty little part of the universe, which, if you remember my cringe fan art review, where that was totally disgusting and disturbing, and also my other video talking about the explicit fan art people post online. I mean, it's terrifying. But we're going to be diving into the dumpster once again to talk about another group that is forming from the loudcest part of it, which is basically where, yeah, Lincoln is doing the dirty with all of his sisters. Yikes. And this little nug, this little dirty jewel, is called Sin Kids. Now, what the fuck is Sin Kids? Well, these are the offspring of these incest meetings. And I didn't know such shit even existed, but there is literally tons of it out there. And there's a whole group of these kids that are that were created from incest. And I don't know all the names of them. There's one named Lupe, which, if I'm correct, quote me if you guys know any of this shit. Lupe is the cross between Lincoln and Lucy. Yikes. And there's another one, I think her name is Leanne or Lyanne. And she is between him and Lenny. And there are two they're a crossbreed between him and Luna. Luna's got two. I don't know their names. I know one, that's another one that's a cross between him and Luann. Her name's Libby. And, yeah. And I know of one, two other ones between him and Lynn. And her name is Lacey. And one more, the one I kind of felt really sorry for. And I feel sorry for all of them just because I'll explain why in a little bit. But the one I, it kind of caught my attention. Like, who the fuck is, I thought originally it was Lori when I first saw it. It was a cross between Lincoln and Lori. And her name is Loann or Loan. And then I found there was a page or whatever, like a fan art page where it explains these different characters. Her full name is Loann or Lone Lee Loud. Middle name's Lee. Lone Lee. That's kind of a pun. But she's schizophrenic. She's jumpy. She slurs her words. She's, yeah. Basically the definition of an inbred product of incest. Swimming in the same genetic pool. And there's been fan fiction written, which I read some of it, fan art made. And I'm like, whoa. I mean, just to see this girl, I mean, she looks like she's disheveled. She's like kind of jittery, you know, she jumps at the slightest little thing. I mean, yeah, I'm like, yeah, that's what happens when brother fucking sister, you know, you're gonna get shit like that. And as I dug into this trash can deeper and deeper, I'm starting to learn more shit. I'm thinking, whoa, that there's people have wrote comics, and I've read some of these comics, and one was of just Loann or whatever, I think her name's Loann, I think, or Loan. I don't know what her actual name is. If you guys know, if anyone from that community watches my video, explain it. Is it Loann or is it like the word loan, like you get like a loan from a bank? Anyway, it was her talking about how, I forget who it is, it was the little abomination made between Lincoln and Lana. She said something about her mother, you know, Lana was gonna die or something, and then something about creating like the perfect backstory for her adventures and crap, and then they were like, what's wrong with her? And then Lincoln said something about, well, for starters, the whole point of the whole fact that Lori came into my room, that was the beginning of the of this terrible thing. I'm thinking, oh my god, what the hell? And they call these kids the kids of sin. They call them the most adorable little abominations you'll ever see. Little abomination is just an underword. I'm thinking these poor little characters are they're genetic disasters that had been created by stupidity. And no, I am not bashing the artists, the writers, and all these people who collaborated together to create these characters. I'm not bashing them one bit. Because the characters, if you see them drawn and stuff, they're pretty well done. Very well done. And I have to give them respect on that. But the whole idea that, you know, the whole concept, it's the concept of how they came to be, because he fucks her and you get Loann or Loan or whatever, he fucking Lenny get you Leanne or whatever, and you know fucking each one of them. And the way it is, it progresses from the oldest to the youngest. But it over time. So it isn't like he's screwing them when they're younger. He screws them as they are older or whatever. And then that's from what I don't really know. But there are several artists on DeviantArt who draw this stuff. And one of them was Jump Around Jump Jump. And sadly, his DeviantArt account isn't nowhere to be found anymore. So I don't know what the hell happened with that. But, you know, it's quite disturbing. You know, the fact that, I mean, some of the couple of fan fictions I've read and the fan art I've seen, I mean, they're really well thought out and very well done. What I don't like is the fact of this loudcest shit. Lincoln screwing Lori, and she's having this, had this abomination, you know, known as Loanne, you know, and I really feel sorry for her. I mean, just the way she acts and just the way everything about her and stuff, and, you know, from reading about her and actually seeing these drawings and stuff, you know, these are all characteristics of somebody who is a product of incest, who is a product of inbreeding. And I really feel honestly sad. Even though, yes, she's a fictional character who was created by a group of Loud House fans and stuff, but still, just to know that this character has all these problems and stuff, and it seems like a lot of the other ones, they don't have problems. I'm thinking people that are incest, you know, creations of that, they have problems. A lot of the other ones don't seem to really have problems. I mean, they have little tics and quirks, but not like this one. No, not like Lori and Lincoln's love child. No, she's almost like a tweaker, like a meth head. She don't even do drugs. Maybe prescription drugs, I don't know. So yeah, what do I think about this sin kids, as they've been coined as, or the adorable little abominations that everybody supposedly likes? I guess it's an okay concept. I'm not going to throw it in the trash and burn it and say, oh, this is terrible shit, you know. I'm not going to bash the idea. I'm not going to bash the people who do it. But I'm not going to, I'm not going to actually condole it either. I'm just going to kind of stay in the middle of it, you know. Yeah, it's an interesting concept, but at the same time, it's kind of disturbing and kind of gross. So, yeah. I will leave a link, couple of links in the description of the video so you guys can see what I'm talking about, and you guys tell me what you think. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope this is the last video of this sort I will do. I hope. If not, then I don't know. But, you know, if you enjoy my content, if you're new to my channel, hit subscribe and turn on notifications, and join the Commodore's crew. And until next time, this is Commodore Urban saying have smooth seas and clear skies, and happy sailing with you, and God bless. Until next time, take care now. Goodbye.